There's no part of my day that I don't love. When I wake up, I'm excited to get up. This is how I define success. I define it as the first 5 seconds in the morning. Am I excited to get up or not?
All that other bullshit is here today and gone tomorrow.
Guys, before we do get into this Life of Ice episode, I just want to thank all you guys who reached out and cop Life Appreciation Club. And you guys are fucking legends. We'd be nothing without you. So just a quick little thank you from me and my team. Appreciate you all. Yo, what's up? Welcome back to Life of Ice episode number 405. I don't know. Back on the wheelie chairs, giving those nostalgic vibes. Man, now I'm filming this, it makes me think about that time we're in Parramatta and they still sort of cruise around like this. She see money all around me. I used to always be in the office by myself, but now I've got a bunch of different staff. It's a position that I've never been in before. I'm grateful for it as well. With it comes problems, and I get that, but I'm grateful for this pressure because not everyone gets to experience it as well. So while I'm back vlogging, first of all, if you did cop some merch, thank you very much. If you're part of the inner circle, thank you very much as well. If you're part of the Doozy Club, we'll be doing giveaways monthly, so make sure you stay tuned for that. So I appreciate all you guys. If you don't even cop merch, love the content, appreciate you still. So now I'm going to be talking about why I got back into vlogging. I just want to document the journey. I know there's people that out there that follow me. I feel like success leaves clues, and now it's time for me to leave clues for people that enjoy following me. I'm 32 years old right now, currently single, live in Bondi, run YKTR Sports. We have 7 staff. Got online courses that I run as well. Got the Ice Project, which has done a few million views, that I'm going to really get back into as well. And I'm just trying to build a life that I really want to live. So I just want to eliminate the doubt that there's luck involved. And I think a lot of people sleep on me as an entrepreneur. And a lot of people forget I was working 16 hours days for like a year and a half without any pay. I was rocking up to the supermarket, gold coins in my hands, just buying noodles, trying to figure out how I'm gonna get fed. When my power got cut off, my car broke down, this all happened within a week as well. And I was just figuring it out. I was just gonna, I can make it through. And I wish I documented those times. I didn't, because I was a little bit embarrassed. A lot of people thought we were killing it, and I just feel like a bit of ego involved. I feel like I didn't want to let anyone down. So these vlogs are back, and when you see YKTR, you'll probably follow it for a bunch of different reasons. You probably love Simi because he's funny and a bit of a fuckwit. Love Scope because Scope's a really good guy and he's leader of the degenerates. You might enjoy Lukey because he's the creative behind this as well. You might enjoy Jackson's journey because you love Vintage Kit. Caleb's this young guy that's super talented, 18 years old, and hopefully he's going to be with us for a long, long time. So there's so many variations of YKTR, but these are just going to be about me, about documenting the journey, about what I do, morning routines, how I get into the position that I'm in, because I'm grateful for the position that I'm in. And I think a lot of the content I'm pumping out right now inside YKTR, all that sort of shit, sort of shows me complaining and sort of shows me in a bad light that I think a lot of people think I'm a micromanager. The content that the boys toss up on outside YKTR is a bit of a giggle, and obviously it's a parody show. People will take that seriously and people start inboxing me and go, oh, you need to start treating the boys better. The boys get treated well. Trust me, the boys get treated very well. Scope and Simi have to work about 3-4 hours a week. Rock up to an office, they get paid to do 3 podcasts a week and 3-6 blogs a week. So that's their job. Don't have to do any of the editing. We cut it up all for them. But do we have fights? Of course, of course. Simi's like a good mate of mine. Scope's a good mate of mine before we even got into business together. So when we talk, like if you watch the last episode of The Oracle, that's just how we normally talk. That's just a normal conversation for us.
Ugly cunt. Hey, what'd you say? Ugly cunt. You're ugly, bro. Fuck, you're pissing me off today. Oh yeah, how did the giveaway go? Was it good?
There are cheeky digs, and there's an element of truth to some of those things as well, but that's just how we talk. That's just how we are, and we really want to show that side as well. But I've never been in this position before. We have 7 staff. I am currently part of 4 or 5 businesses at the moment in terms of equity. I'm watching this back and I sound like the cockiest guy. I don't normally talk like this, but I just want to get this point across. I'm in a position now where I've built my personal brand up a little bit, where people start offering me equity within businesses as well. So I'm going to show you guys those meetings. I don't know, like a lot of people watch YKTR for a bunch of different reasons, and if you're following me for me and you're interested in entrepreneurship and trying to build a lifestyle that you love, like there's no part of my day that I don't love. When I wake up, I'm excited to get up. This is how I define success. I define it as the first 5 seconds in the morning. Am I excited to get up or not? So that every part of my life I love, and I can show people how to build this as well. And there's gonna be different variations of success for you guys, but I just really wanna show this. I just really wanna know that success leaves clues behind. Now it's time for me to leave some of those clues behind for you guys as well. Like when I drive to work every morning, I think about YKTR and I think about YKTR Sports. And when I say that, I think I can build the best clothing brand that adds the most value to people's lives. And when I say that I want to build a sports media company that can change the narrative and connect players to fans and fans to players, like there's not a single cell in my body that doesn't believe that. Like even when I say that now, it gives me goosebumps, man, because I feel like I can do it, eh? So this is what these vlogs are going to be about. I don't know, it's just going to be me being me. I think a lot of people see the business version of me as well, and I can speak in that terms, and I can have a conversation with someone like Mar Boras, but then I can go talk shit to the boys as well. So I'm just going to show the real version of me in all aspects of life. So hope you guys enjoy.
Got goosebumps, eh?
Where's the subscribe, man?